بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Ahmed Tawfiq and my friend Dr. Muhammad Iqbal for their kind treatment here in Egypt and for the invitation to attend the Egyptian Protocol for Platforms Management, the said version. And I will take the chance to thank Professor Dr. Osama Ibrahim and Professor Dr. Ahmed Abdelkarim Masri. I work with them since 2004 in Sudan, and both of them initiated the work of refractive surgery in Sudan. Thank you very much. So, the previous session mainly talked about the surgical options for platelet management. So I will deviate from them and talking about the impact of hybrid DKRGV contact lenses on eyes with keratoconus. Okay. All of us know that the keratoconus is one of the most primary cases. And it is with unknown etiology, actually, as the previous report said. So the incidence of this condition is varies between countries. Actually, we have researched before about the main causes of keratoconus. Actually, all books saying there is no etiology of keratoconus, but there is associations. And we found in our research there is association between keratoconus and asthma. Eczema, all the atopic problems, and also some reporter says that there is genetic factors in this condition, and recently there is work between in keratoconus and diabetes. So the optically the RGB contact lens is the most option for treatment, and actually in this study we have presented new contact lenses with very high DK material. Okay. Many contact lenses, hard contact lenses were designed for controlling keratoconus, but there is difference between these lenses regarding visual outcome, ocular surface gains, and complications. The hybrid DK RGB used in these studies from Minicon, Japan, and it is not yet available while in the market and not yet studied. So evaluation of this lens may contribute in the field of management of keratoconus. So we expected benefits such as this lens will build the good lens for the management of condition. So the objective from this study is to evaluate the effect of wearing hybrid DK RGB contact lens on corneal topography, corneal thickness, indices of cell morphology, and tear stability. And this study actually took around 12 months follow. Okay. We use a Bellerophon chart and a Snelling chart for visual acuity measurement and contrast sensitivity respectively. And we use the slit lamp and fluorescein to evaluate the tear stability or tear quality. We use a slit lamp by microscopy for evaluation of contact lens fitting and monitoring the complications that could arise from the fitting. And we use an OBD machine, optical bus difference, from NIDIC for corneal topography, and TOPCON, non-contact spectral microscope, to evaluate the central corneal thickness and indices of cell morphology. And we also design the visual analog scale to evaluate the comfortability of patients with this contact lens. Actually, I just evaluated these two versions, ROS-K2 and ROS-K2 IC contact hard contact lenses. And there is from the same family, ROS-KNC and ROS-K burst graph. And actually, I have a chance to evaluate them. So as I mentioned before, this lens represents the higher DK material available in the world now, and this is the name, the chemical and the chemical name of the contact lens. In terms of design, this lens is designed to reduce aberrations that arises from the anterior and posterior surface of the lens difference. So the His design was a spherical design. Front and back surface were parallel each to other. That means the optic zone same as the center surface and the back surface. And it also designed with a large optical zone from 7 to 8 millimeters.
Okay.
So let's go to directly to the result. Actually, we studied a total of 23 subjects and with mean age of 26 years of old. Only 17 subjects actually completed the study with dropout rate of 25%. So yes, so there is significant improvement in visual acuity and contrast sensitivity with RGB compared to spectacle at baseline, and also between baseline visual acuity is RGB and after 1 year of wearing the lens. The figures here illustrate this variation. Non-parametric tests indicate no significant improvement in visual acuity throughout the study period. I mean that from the first week of fitting until the 1 year of fitting. But there is significant improvement of contrast sensitivity at the end of the study. So also the figures illustrate this one very well. Sorry. Here contrast sensitivity just going rising until 12 months and visual acuity just stable all the period. In terms of the spherical equivalent of refraction, there is no difference between the baseline measures and the 1 year follow-up.
So
in terms of corneal thickness, there is significant reduction in central corneal thickness after 12 months of wearing high-del VKRGB contact lens. And there is no significant change, coefficient variation from the serial cell size, hexagonality of cells, and industrial cell density through the study period. With regard to corneal topography, Wilcoxon non-parametric test indicates there is no intermediate change in the mean keratometric reading after 1 year of RGB, but there is significant reduction in mean keratometric reading and corneal astigmatism throughout the study period. That means there is corneal flattening here. No significant change also was noticed at the steel stability, so the steel films remain stable and for when compared the baseline with the sessions of visits. And comfortability increased significantly during the wearing of contact lens and also towards the end of the study. So here I'm just showing the Zillig bonimal for the corneal aberrations that are induced by keratoconus, and actually this is the main cause of poor vision, not the keratoconus itself. The reduction of vision is usually coming from these types of aberrations. About from our study is the lower diagram. We compare between two designs of contact lens, silicon hydrogel contact lens. We used soft Curasoft IC and rigid gas permeable contact lens. We use the high-del RGB contact lens. So it's very clear that RGB contact lens reduces all types of aberrations. Here I want to present one of my patients. She's 16 years old from Indian origin. We used to take topography and aberration map without contact lens, and with silicon hydrogel contact lens, and with RGB contact lens. It's very clear that there is no significant of astigmatism and at the RGB lens, and there is reduction in corneal aberration. So here, just comparing our results with previous reports, we found that this high-del-decay RGB contact lens is aberration control design improved vision significantly compared to previous reports and also improved contrast sensitivity. in terms of central corneal sickness, as we use the highest decay material, we found that there is no significant, there is reduction, which expected in this lens because the, maybe it is due to the normal progression of keratoconus. There is no change in previous reports, and they found that the decay materials play a role in this condition. So in terms of corneal topography, we found that there is flattening effect, and we attribute this change to the pressure of the thin film staying between the contact lens and the anterior surface of the cornea. As usually we fit our patient with apical clearance contact lens fit. There is no change actually, as we mentioned, in the CSL morphology. And this result, we attribute the fact that because we use higher decay material, other lenses used in previous report, they use it with low decay material. So there is no interaction between the contact lens and tear film, so that means tear film is stable all the time. And level of comfort increased because there is no significant change, or there is no complication such as gain papillary conjunctivitis or conjunctival hyperemia or staining. All this we assume as complication of contact lens wear. So we can conclude that the material and design of hyperdecay RGB contact lens used in this study showed positive effect on control of keratoconus, and actually to avoid complications arises from hypoxia and others, so we need to describe our patient with this type of contact lens. As I mentioned before, we have to prescribe such contact lens. I'm not sure that it's available in Egypt or not. It is not yet in Sudan actually. So we just have the trial set, but we have to get it from outside our countries. So I think it will come soon to this area. Apart from this study, actually already published in many journals. Thank you for your attention.